currently protecting and fighting alongside the country.
وعلى أهداف الثورة في بناء دولة مدنية ديمقراطية تكفل التبادل السلبي للسلطة وتحفظ الحريات وتصون الحقوق.
Standing with the revolution and fighting for the rule of civil society and strengthening the stability of our country.
سنمر على عدد من القضايا الأساسية التي تستحوذ على اهتمامنا. البداية قرار مجلس الأمن الأخير يوم الأربعاء الماضي طبعا يدعو ضمن جملة من البنود إلى وقف دائم لإطلاق النار.
We are going to cover a few areas today. Among them the latest resolution at the Security Council which consolidates and protects the ceasefire.
ليصبح بذلك أول نص ملزم يصدر عن مجلس الأمن منذ بدء العدوان من يوم 4/4/2019.
And with that marking the first binding resolution that has appeared since the beginning of the fighting and the aggression on our city on the 4th of April 2019.
هذا القرار يتبنى مخرجات مؤتمر برلين التي صدرت في 19 يناير والتي تصبح بدورها إلزامية للجميع.
These resolutions embodies what we have reached at Berlin's conferences in January and becomes the first step into making them complete and realizing.
مؤتمر برلين يؤكد أن الخيار العسكري حل مستحيل وهذه الاستحالة صنعها بركان أبطال بركان الغضب.
The Berlin conference renders and embodies the fact that there is no resolution, there is no solution with armament, that the only solution is via civil debates, and this has only been made possible by those sacrifices and the efforts rendered by the people who are fighting among the Burkhan Ghadab forces.
وهي تعني فشل مشروع دخول العاصمة والانقلاب على السلطة الشرعية.
Which marks the failure to a siege and enter the city by force as the aggressor has planned.
مؤتمر برلين أجمع على أن الحل السياسي لإنهاء الحرب هو الحل الوحيد للخروج من الأزمة الليبية وقرر اعتماد ثلاثة مسارات متوازنة الأول المسار العسكري والأمني الثاني المسار السياسي والمسار الاقتصادي.
The Berlin conferences has reached a consensus which is that there is no solution but the political dialogue and has also embodies or came up with three different axes in order to reach this agreement and this consensus. The axis of military and security as well as political as well as economical.
المسار العسكري والأمني وهو الآن تبحثه اللجنة 5+5 سنركز على هذا المسار لأنه يقضي بوقف دائم لإطلاق النار وفي رأينا أنه بدون وقف دائم لإطلاق النار الحديث على باقي المسار يبقى نوع من العبث.
The first axis which is the security and military which we're going to focus on today because obviously it is the most prominent one is going to take us to the efforts that are being taken by the commission of 5+5 in order to render this ceasefire as a permanent solution and permanent ceasefire which is the priority right now.
فلا مفاوضات تحت قصف الطائرات واستمرار نزيف الدماء ودمار البنى التحتية.
There cannot be any dialogue while the wars and the cannons and the bombardments are continuing. We cannot continue to do anything until we make this ceasefire a reality and permanent.
الاتفاق على وقف دائم لإطلاق النار يعني وقف جميع الأعمال العدائية عودة النازحين وضمان عدم تعرض العاصمة والمدن الأخرى لأي تهديدات.
The permanence of a ceasefire means that there will be no longer any activities of war, there will no longer be any aggressions, there will not be any bombing. It also embodies the return of those internally displaced to their homes and the returns of the forces to where they came from and no other activities of a military nature.
رحبنا سابق وعلنا الالتزام بقرار مجلس أمن ومقررات برلين، لكن لم نتخلى عن الحذر وأخذ الحيطة، لأننا ندرك أن ليس لدينا شريك للسلام.
We have welcomed but carefully the resolution of the Security Council for the ceasefires and all the efforts taken. However, we are very cautious because we are acknowledging the fact that we do not have a true partner for the peace at the moment.
فلم يسبق للطرف المعتدي أن التزم بتفاهمات أقرها، فالتراجع والنقوص صفة ملازمة لتصرفاته من خلال مؤتمرات سابقة ولقاءات سواء كانت في باريس أو باليرمو أو أبوظبي.
As we recall, the partner that we have believed in previously has taken steps back in previous commitments that he has taken, whether it is in Paris or whether it is in Palermo or other conferences in which we have had agreed on several points.
وقد ثبت الجميع أنه يسعى للسلطة وللسلطة فقط ولو كانت على جثة جميع الليبيين.
And the actions or his latest actions has proven in front of everyone that the priority and the objective is to reach power by any means necessary, including by climbing on the bodies of those who he has caused their deaths.
الجميع لاحظ ازدياد الخروقات والتجاوزات منذ صدور مجلس الأمن، فلم تتوقف الميليشيات المعتدية عن قصف الأحياء السكنية في طرابلس.
Everyone has noticed the increasing numbers in breaches in the resolutions of the Security Councils, including the bombing and the shelling of civil areas, including homes and residential areas, killing countless innocent civilians.
فالسياق الوحيد لفهم تحركات حكومة الوفاق هو الدفاع المشروع عن النفس.
Which warrants to the GNA.